Welcome. I hope everyone is staying safe and healthy in these crazy times. Today, I'm going to tell you a little bit about the Heidelberg Project. The Heidelberg Project is a two-block outdoor art environment in the heart of an urban area whose name stems from its location on Heidelberg Street in East Detroit, Michigan. The Detroit-based community organization functions with a mission to improve the lives of people and neighborhoods through art. The theory of change for the Heidelberg Project begins with the belief that all citizens from all cultures have the right to grow and flourish in their communities. The Heidelberg Project believes that a community can redevelop and sustain itself from the inside out by embracing its diverse cultures and artistic attributes as the essential building blocks for a fulfilling and economically viable way of life. So, a little background on how all this began. In 1986, artist Tyree Guyton returned to Heidelberg, the street where he grew up on Detroit's east side, and found it in shambles, riddled with drugs and deepening poverty. Empowered by the loss of his three brothers to the same streets, Guyton was encouraged by his grandfather to pick up a paintbrush instead of a weapon and to look for a solution. Armed with a paintbrush, a broom, and the neighborhood children, Guyton and Grandpa began by cleaning up vacant lots on Heidelberg Street. From the found objects and garbage they collected, Guyton transformed the street into a massive art environment. Vacant lots literally became lots of art, and abandoned houses became gigantic art sculptures. Guyton not only transformed vacant houses and lots, but he integrated the streets, the sidewalks, and trees into his mammoth installations and called the work, the entire street, the Heidelberg Project. In 1988, the Heidelberg Project was officially incorporated, and the project set out to inspire people to appreciate and use artistic expression to enrich their lives and to improve the social and economic health of the greater community. The Heidelberg Project was born out of Guyton's own experiences and hardships, growing up in a community that had experienced devastating changes. What used to be a diverse working-class neighborhood over the years became a community characterized by violence, racism, abandonment, despair, and poverty. Once home to over 300 African-American-owned businesses, the community was virtually destroyed as a result of the 1967 riots, and such conditions became the pretext for the birth of what is known today as the Heidelberg Project. Guyton systematically rearranges the existing landscape on Heidelberg Street by incorporating found objects, the street, the trees, the sidewalks, abandoned houses, vacant lots, nature, and even the people. To this end, Guyton's work was met by some with fierce disdain, and in the first 18 years became the subject of great controversy and heated debates all across Detroit. Guyton claimed that his art was a medicine for the people and that the pros and cons were just a part of the process. But the project was met with bulldozers in 1991 and again in 1999. But each time the project wouldn't be stopped, and each time it came back stronger and more profound. The Heidelberg Project works to dispel fear and brings in more than 275,000 visitors annually from all over the world. 140 of the 195 countries in the world are documented as having been to the Heidelberg Project. Guyton refers to the work being done at the project as Heidelbergology, which he defines as the study of artist materials, i.e. found objects, incorporated into the fabric and landscape of an urban community and the effect on that community. When he reappropriates found and discarded items from in and around the community to create new and beautiful works of art, he does this as a metaphor to help us understand how we can begin to start recycling the minds of the people in his community. He calls this style of art creative placemaking and often discusses how the creative principles can be used to create change and to awaken the human spirit. He refers to three principles of Heidelbergology. The first of which is abstract advocacy, which he defines as the introduction of new information that in the short term changes attitudes, but in the long term changes behavior. He gives the example of a 26-year resident of Heidelberg Street who spent 25 years advocating against the Heidelberg Project, who hated living there and would go on local news and talk shows to discuss how much of an eyesore and a nuisance the project was. But after 25 years of living and hating the Heidelberg Project, she decided she needed to repaint her home. Instead of contracting the work and paying for it for herself, she invited the visitors to her street to sign her home and to paint decorations in exchange for a donation. And with the help of these visitors, she transformed her home into a work of art. She was quoted as saying, "I spent so much time being angry when I could have been having fun. Now I meet people from all over the world without ever leaving my front porch." The second principle he refers to is art as medicine, and it's basically the concept that the Heidelberg Project is viewed as a rehabilitation program for convicted criminals and others without work in the community. The third principle he refers to is art as a catalyst for change, which he defines as employing the community members, neighbors, and friends. The Heidelberg Project has become a beacon of hope in the community and is recognized as the third most visited cultural destination in all of Detroit. The Heidelberg Project generates about $3.4 million annually for Detroit tourism, but even after 30 plus years in operation, the project is still faced with opposition. In 2013, arsonists began to target the project and caused major devastation. 12 fires in just over 12 months ruined most of the still-standing homes on Heidelberg Street. But nothing can stop Tyree Guyton. He looks at the homes that have been destroyed in the fires as new blank canvases to create from. Even with the continued opposition from the forces that be, the medicine appears to have had a healing effect. Residents who would have never visited the Detroit Institute of Arts or the Detroit Symphony Orchestra have become educated about art and participate in the Heidelberg Project programs, festivals, and forums. The Heidelberg Project provides modest jobs and an outdoor space in which members of the community can come together to play, reflect, create, and interact with people from all over the world. This practice builds a sense of self-worth and pride in the community. And this pride then becomes the protection of the Heidelberg Project and is a demonstration of its success. This practice explains how the Heidelberg Project site remains undisrupted in a community that is quite literally desecrated. More than 30 years of renewing the human spirit can now successfully translate into rebuilding the community. So I leave you with some questions to consider. Why do you think the Heidelberg Project has been met with continuous opposition in the 30 plus years it's been in operation? How can we use art as a catalyst for change in our own lives and communities? Why do you think Guyton uses the Heidelberg Street as a central location to the project? And why not show his art elsewhere? Why do you think the Heidelberg Project has gained global attention? Why do people come from all over the world to see this work? And how and where else might creative placemaking as a practice be useful? Thank you all so much for listening, and I hope you all have a wonderful day.